guys, so today I'm going to be filming my summer favorites. It's been a while since I've done any sort of favorites. I have a monthly favorites coming up at the end of this month, which has more like makeup related favorites, while this video has more things that I, you know, like using the summer sunscreen, sunglasses, stuff like that. So my monthly favorites would be super long. I thought I would separate things a little bit. So if you're looking for like favorite foundations and all that good stuff, wait a few weeks. Like less than two, and you'll get that video. The first thing I wanted to talk about would be Scentbird. I've used them before. If you watched one of my monthly favorites around like October, it was when I first signed up with them, and I really like the concept. It's pretty affordable. It's a subscription service, a monthly subscription for fragrance, and it's $15 a month, and you get to try a new fragrance every month. It's not a full-size fragrance, but it's pretty reasonable because I've always thought like perfumes cost way too much in store. Like I always buy roller balls. I rarely get the full bottle. I have to really love a scent to get the full bottle of something, and it takes forever. I usually try to pick like a few signature scents for that season, and then I don't switch up. I wear like the same one every day. So I got a couple new ones, and I really like them. If you aren't interested in like a monthly subscription, you can buy them just a la carte for $17, so it's only $2 more. It's a little pricier, but I mean, if you don't want to commit to something, then that's cool too. So what it is it comes in this cute little like packaging, and inside has a different fragrance, which you can just swap out your container if you want like to carry a pink one all the time, and it has the name of the fragrance on the vial, and then otherwise you just twist it in and out, and then you can just spritz it. I have different color vials. So some of my favorites right now. The first one, I honestly, me being the person who can't pronounce anything, I can't pronounce it, but it is very, very nice. Let's see. It's really subtle. It reminds me a lot of my Chloe perfume, which is my like signature scent. So if you like Chloe, you'll like this a lot. Scentbird also has like a perfume quiz, so you can kind of match up like, do you like fresh scents? Do you like musky scents? Do you like fruity scents? And then gives you recommendations. So I have like a whole page of things that I pretty much already own, and then I try to pick and choose from the other ones I don't. This one smells really good though. It's subtle. It's like definitely like a more mature scent, but it's not like musky or anything like that. It's not like sweet pea sweet, but it's a sweet, fresh, clean scent. I couldn't decide this month, and I decided to get two, and this is the Ralph Lauren Romance. This is awesome though. It's more like aquatic. It's very, I don't know how to describe scents aside from like fruity, sour, and sweet, but this one makes you feel like you're really clean. It's something like a really fresh, like I would say like ocean would smell like, but not salty at all. It's really nice. I love Ralph Lauren scents. I love even their men's line, like their Polo line is amazing. I tried the scent of the month for Scentbird right now, which is by Malin and Gotez, and it's the, I can't pronounce things, it's horrible, but this is a super like kitcheny scent. It's very lemon, lime, citrusy. If you guys like that, this was my third choice, so I was like, oh, it's the scent of the month, might as well check it out. It's really like limey, which I like lime, but I don't know if I would be the type to wear a lime a lot. It's definitely something that makes you want to drink a limeade or go sit by the beach for sure. They're all really travel friendly, nice and sleek and affordable, so it's definitely something that I would recommend if you're into trying different scents or wants like gift a small scent just in case someone doesn't like it or something like that. If you're interested in checking out Scentbird, I have a 25% off coupon code down below and on the screen for your first fragrance. Moving on to some other things that I am loving this month. My sunscreen that I picked up at Target randomly. I got this for one of the outside like workout events I was going to. It's called Mega Shea, and I just need something really quick. So I was at Target and I got this Neutrogena Cool Dry Sport with Micro Mesh sunscreen, SPF 50. So this is supposed to keep you cool if you sweat. So it's really good for workouts or if you just generally like perspirate a lot. This has a cool, clean feel when your sweat evaporates away. And it's supposed to be water resistant for 80 minutes. This stuff is really nice. It doesn't feel like you're wearing sunscreen. It doesn't leave a stinky like sunscreen smell or a white cast at all, which is exactly what I needed. It's probably one of the only spray-on sunscreens I've ever liked in my life. Otherwise, I'm like, ugh, it's too much. Too sticky. I don't want to like rub it in. It just is really easy. It comes on kind of clear and I just rub it in real quick, like a swipe or two, and then I'm good. I don't know if it really left me super cool because I was like out on a really hot day the last time I wore this, but it didn't make me feel gross afterwards. I definitely felt like good after like all my sweat dried off, and it wasn't like heavy, which is something I look for definitely in a sunscreen. For my face, I've been using the Tatcha Silk-In Pore Perfecting Sunscreen with SPF 35. This does apply like a white thick cream, but I usually put a little bit on my hand and blend in some sort of serum or something to thin it out a little bit, moisturizer, and make it less like white casty. And it blends in really nice, and it almost works kind of like a primer too. So sometimes I'll wear it with my makeup and it leaves my face really poreless, which I like. So it has Japanese wild rose, silk extracts that are supposed to reduce the appearance of pores and leave skin looking beautifully brightened. So I like it. A little bit goes a long way. It's kind of pricey. It's available at Sephora if you guys want to check that out. I'll link it off down below. A lot of Tatcha stuff is a little pricey, but I've always been very satisfied with all their products, so some good stuff. As far as bug repelling goes, if you haven't seen my arm yet in this video, I have bug bites, so this is kind of a bad testimony. But I wasn't wearing this when I got my bug bites. So I just came back from BeautyCon trip to LA. I got bit there. I didn't bring anything to like protect from bugs because it wasn't something I was thinking about. I even left my eyeshadow palettes at home, if you can believe that, by accident. But when I'm at home, usually if I'm going out, I'm going to like work on my car, go to the pool, or just generally go out on a hot day where I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get bit up. I'm wearing a crop top and shorts. I go with this. This is not really a bug repellent, but it's known to be good to repel bugs. So I get this on Amazon. This is the Avon Skin So Soft bath oil spray, and it is pretty good, I would say. I haven't had any issues. Anytime I wear this, I never get bit at all. So I kind of use it as like a body oil, which is what it is. I spray it on, it leaves me a little glisten, makes my legs look kind of healthy, and it smells good. It has like a cottony scent, so it's not like a obnoxious, oh, chemically bug repellent, ew, you stink, girl, walk away. I'll use this on days I don't even go out, like after taking a bath, and I like it a lot. They only sell them in big sizes or bulk packs on Amazon for some reason now, but it has a lot of reviews. If you read on Amazon at all, everyone's talking about how it like repels bugs. So I've been using that for 2 years now, still my go-to favorite. I don't really care to use like Off or Off Deep Woods or anything like that anymore. It's just not my thing. I've tried those little like bands, they don't work for me, but this seems to work the large majority of the time. Another summer favorite would be these sunglasses. They're from Key Australia. I was saying Quay for the longest time, and I'm not surprised because I mispronounce everything. But these are the Baron shades. They're so pretty. I'm trying to not like shine my light at you guys. I don't look good in a lot of sunglasses. I'll be honest, I really don't. I wear Key Australia's pointy shades. Those are like the Quay X Shea, Shea Mitchell collection sunglasses. Those are my favorite last year, and these are my new favorites, and they're like $50, so they're not super super expensive, and they wear well. Like, I haven't had any issues with them like breaking or anything like that. I like the matte black ones a lot. It's kind of my style, but they have like torte and white, and sometimes they have like blue frames, stuff like that. I never pick the styles that have any of the cool frames, but this is what it looks like on. I like square frames a lot because my face doesn't look very good with like very round frames. So the coolest thing I could do was like the pointy ones I mentioned earlier, and that was because it had the same type of bottom as these. It still does leave a little print on the side of my nose, but it doesn't like sit on my face weird. They're pretty comfortable, and they're just high enough to cover the brows. So they're good for the days that, you know, I don't have any makeup on and I wanna like look like I'm presentable. I like them a lot. I wish I looked good in aviators, but this is the best your girl can do. Their really popular shade type was the My Girl ones, and they look horrible on me, honestly. I look like Miss Piggy because it puts too much space next to my nose, and then my face looks really round and my nose looks huge no matter how much I contour. So I was lucky enough to find that these work really well, and I think I got them directly from their website, but Amazon sells them, and then Shoptobi sells them. A lot of different sites, like probably Urban Outfit or something like that, sells them. And you can see these in PacSun too, but I've never seen this style. As far as summer goes, I need headbands with my extensions on because they're taped in. I have them the large majority of summer, so I just get really affordable headbands. Like this is like a cute one from Forever 21. That you can bend the ears if you want to, but we're not gonna do that. We're gonna lay them flat because there's like a metal wire in them. And they are really affordable, like $2 to $3. I buy a bunch. I got like 8 for $30 or something like that. It was really, really good. And I like them all. They're all different textures, colors, fabrics, and different widths. And this is what I usually do. It looks like I tied a bandana around my head, but I really didn't because it has like the scrunchy thing in the back. And that's what I usually do whenever I don't feel like doing my hair, worried about like the wind blowing my extensions around too much that day or something like that. I just put on a headband. It's a nice way to just get my hair out of my face and look a little presentable. I almost bought some really expensive headbands I saw on Instagram, and I was like, you know what? No. Forever 21. I'm kind of cheap when it comes to that. They also fit my daughter's heads too, like surprisingly. Some of the styles are kind of tight, so on them it's a little looser, but it's so freaking cute. Okay, I have two more things to talk about. First being my White with Style kits. I've been trying out new flavors. I talked about this, I think like February or something like that, and I got the strawberry kit back then. I'm pretty much out of it, so I decided to try two new flavors. I have the cotton candy one, which is the blue bag, and then I have the mint one. That's the regular mint, not the peroxide free. And I still like strawberry the best. Little disclaimer, it's my favorite. It's your typical teeth whitening kit where it comes with a light that you just click on like this. And then the difference for this kit for me from other kits I've used prior to this is that it comes with mouth guards. So you just like put in hot water and mold them to your teeth, and then you fill the trays, stick the light in, wear it for up to 20 minutes. So I will say that it doesn't make my teeth any more sensitive than usual, but I definitely can feel it when it's working, if that makes any sense. So I don't have problems eating like whole foods or anything like that. So that's something I like about it. It's pretty affordable. You can get this for as low as $28, which is very, very affordable, and it has 10 uses in the bag. So I thought that's really, really good. You have to use my coupon code or a coupon code to get it for $28. Otherwise, it's like 200 something, and that's a little crazy. But it comes with a light, syringes like this, and each line represents a use. So there's like 10 uses on the syringe. Cotton candy was okay. Mint was okay as well, but strawberry is literally my favorite. It doesn't taste like crazy sugary or anything like that, but it leaves like a subtle strawberry taste in your mouth, which is nice. Cotton candy wasn't as sweet as I expected it to be, so that was kind of like a But yeah, it depends on what you like. They have birthday cake too. I think they have like lemon and a bunch of different flavors, and that's kind of why I wanted to try them in the first place, because a lot of things only come with like mint or bubblegum, and that's just not my thing. If you want to see me actually use them, you can check out the video that was probably over here. That's like from my second channel where I was using them, if you want like a demo. Last but not least, I have nail polish shades. One I'm wearing right now, it's the OPI Tiramisu for Two. And these are gel polishes. I typically only rock gel polishes lately because they last longest on me, and it keeps my nails from breaking, which is nice because they're nice and like thick, if that makes sense, or I don't know. Gel polish just lasts longer just from how they're formulated. And I like how with the UV light they dry really fast. So I'm the type to always mess up my nails less than 5 minutes after I paint them, and it's just like, why did I even bother? All of them like start scrunching up and have dents in them. So I love Tiramisu for Two. I've been wearing it for like 8 months, not straight, but it's been my favorite. I bought it on Amazon because this was the polish I was using at my salon. I was like, I need to know what this is. I need to have it at home when I started doing my own gel nail polishes at home. And the other shade is Back to Cali. They're very similar. Ooh, almost dropped it. Tiramisu for Two is a little bit more pinky. It's like a pinky nude, almost like a little hint of peach, but it's like a pinky nude. While Back to Cali is like a gray pinky nude. It's more like neutral, like a light lilac without being too purple, like a light lilac. Pink gray. Does that make any sense? It's really, really pretty. I like the name Back to Cali because I go to Cali so often for trips. And it's very nice that both these are neutral enough that you can wear it with anything. It doesn't clash with my hair, it doesn't clash with my outfit. It looks really good on the feet. I've used both of these on your feet. Some polishes always look like better on your hands and feet. These both are amazing. I love them both, and I'll link them off down below if you guys are interested in checking these out, because I like nudes a lot for summer. Like, I like darker shades for fall, like gray tones, purples and stuff like that. But for summer, I like peachy nudes. I have another peach one from Madame Gam called Games People Play, and that one's really pretty too. So those are like my top three, because you know, you're wearing bolder colors in the summer, like maxi dresses, a lot of brown sandals, you know, wedges. It just goes really well with everything. So those are all of my summer favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed hearing about them. I'll leave as many links, coupon codes as I can in the info box, is what I usually try to do. And I will talk about like my favorite mask and my favorite, like, you know, whatever's on my face, like highlighters and stuff, in my monthly favorites, so that's coming up very soon. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.